Hey everyone, it's Brenda. I'm gonna do a quick video, a baby blanket on the basket weave. And I've got, I did my slip knot and I chained on 22 stitches. Now a regular basket weave, there's a few ways you could do it. But what I'm gonna show you, what I do, is I like to have the knit borders. So you want to do it in multiples of four. So I add two, so I did 22. So I'm gonna knit my border, then I'm gonna knit four. So you're knitting five total. Then I'm gonna purl four. You put the yarn around to the front for purl. And then you're gonna knit four. You don't have to do the knit border, it's just what I prefer. And then you're gonna bring your yarn around to purl four. Push it through the front for purl. And then you're gonna knit four. And knit your border. So, a normal basket weave, you could just do multiples of four, like I said, and do 20 stitches versus 22 if you didn't want to have the knit border. So I'm going to repeat this for four rows, so three more rows. We're going to knit the border and then knit four. Purl four. So you're just repeating this pattern that we just did. And then knit four. And bring your yarn to the front to purl four again. And then you knit four. And knit your border. So we're gonna knit and knit four. And then purl four again. We'll complete this row and do one more row of this pattern. Knit four. And purl four. Again, on your purls, you're just bringing it to the front of your stitch to push it through to the back. I try and keep those stitches a little tighter, pulling it tight. And then you're gonna knit four. And knit your border. Make sure you don't get this twisted on the border. Okay, we are going to knit one and then knit four. This is the Cold Sea Big Brunette Blanket. Now we're going to purl four. And knit four. And again, bring your yarn to the front for the purl four. Knit knit four. And knit one for the border. Okay, we are gonna knit one for the border, and now we're gonna change the pattern to the opposite. So we're gonna purl four. And then we're gonna knit four, because we purled here previous row. And then purl four. And knit four again. Okay, now we're back to the knit. Purl four. And then we're going to knit our border. And again, knit your border and repeat the row you just did. So four purls. Four knits. And you're going to start to see your pattern forming now. Now we're going to do four purls. And four knits. Four purls. You might find a string in there. Just toss it aside. And your knit stitch for the border. Do another knit. And four purls. Knit four. And then bring it again to the front to do your purl four. Knit four. So we'll do one more row of this. Purl four. And knit four. Four and knit four. So now we've almost completed two sections. Purl four. And knit your border. We're gonna go back to the other, the first four rows. So the opposite again of what you were doing. So you knit your border. And then knit four. Purl four. And knit four. 4. And knit 4. And then knit your border. Okay, so I'm gonna do 3 more rows of this pattern. Of the one we just did, knit your border, knit 4, and then purl 4. Knit 4. Knit 4. And then knit your border. Knit your border again. Knit 4. And then knit purl 4. And if you ever get to where you're not sure how many rows you have to do, you can just either count. I mean, I like to count the purls, which is 1, 2, 3, or, and then you can also count the knit stitches. So you can see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So we're going to do 1 more row after this, and then we'll switch it again. Knit 4. And knit your border. Knit your border. Knit 4. Purl 4. Knit 4. Purl 4. And then knit 4. And then again, knit your border stitch. I am gonna just go ahead. Now we're gonna go back and repeat the 4 purls, since we've done 4 rows of that pattern. And I'm not gonna talk anymore until we get to the cast off. Thank you. Okay, I'm gonna do one more pattern of stitches. So I'm gonna do the opposite of what I just did, just to finish off the blanket. So I'm gonna knit the border, knit four, knit four, and then knit your border, and we'll repeat another row of that. More strings. Your knits and purl your purls. Four knits. Four purls. Now for me, the way that I'm knitting with 22 cast on, it's going to be approximately a 30 by 35 or 36 baby blanket. And I will be, have used 3 skeins of the Cold Sea Big Brunette blanket yarn. Pearls. I like to keep my baby blankets around 30 inches wide and 35 inches long. If you're doing a crib blanket, you probably want it longer. And again, you can do your borders whichever way you like. Some people like to do, you know, the regular basket weave without the knit borders. And if you like to do that, you can do that. Or you can, you know, put a border around the blanket. That'd look really cute too. So, after this row, I am going to cast off. So how I'm going to cast off is I take your end stitch and the next stitch on my finger, pinch the working yarn and pull it through. And then you just keep doing that. Take the next stitch, pinch your working yarn, pull it through to make one loop. Take the next stitch, pull it through. And this is how I do cast off. I'm sure there's another way. actually gonna have even a little bit of my third skein left, so not quite three. All right, we have our last loop. I'll cut it off and put your working yarn back through, cinch it tight. I tie a knot, some people don't. Trim it off, and then just like you've seen other people do, I just tuck it in, and then I take a needle and thread and sew that in on both start and finish ends. So you see where we're at. I will take my camera and move it. This is your basket weave.